Adekunle Ajashin University, Akungba Akoko Ondo State, Nigeria, was established by the Ondo State government in November 1999. This was consequent upon the need to relocate the former Ondo State University from its original site, which had fallen into another state following the creation of a new state out of Ondo 3 years earlier. Thus, at creation, the university did not have the privilege of the painstaking planning, infrastructure, equipment, and tools needed for effective takeoff. It faced considerable challenge relating to shortage of classroom, office, and laboratory space, and above all, instability in leadership. While commendable efforts were made to tackle these challenges in the first decade of the university's existence, it was not under the emergence of Professor Femi Mimiko as the institution's fourth substantive vice-chancellor in January 2010 that a real turnaround in the fortunes of Adekunle Ajashin University began. Ever since, for AAUA, it has been a success story. Present, AAUA has a little over 14,000 students, 1,404 academic, administrative, and technical staff, and 6 faculties: agriculture, arts, education, law, science, and social and management sciences. In addition to these are the postgraduate school, the library, and academic support facilities like the Computer Center and Institute of Education, the Institute of Part-Time Programs, the Center for Diploma and Pre-Degree Programs, the Entrepreneurship Development Center, and the Center for General Studies. As at today, AAUA has managed to secure accreditation for all its courses, academic and professional, in line with the university's vision to be a foremost university committed to moving manpower development in the direction of self-apprenticeship. Over the years, successive administrations have endeavored to uplift the institution in all ramifications, always seeking to be a first-class university in research, knowledge, character, and service to humanity, as outlined in its mission statement. The university has focused on the expansion of infrastructures, enhancement of student support services, and deepening of the integrity of its academic programs. In line with its resolve to build a 21st century university, properly called, the administration took off carrying out wide-ranging reforms, building institutions as pillars for transforming the university from relative obscurity to national and global reckoning.
For the past 6 or 7 years now, the admission policy of Adekunle Ajashin has improved tremendously, and we can say that every student admitted to this institution was based on merit. All admission for the past 7 or 6 years always on merit. Like myself, for example, now I got my admission without knowing anybody because I scored a high mark in Aposuemi compared to what we have been hearing for the past few years. So
I didn't know anybody after securing a very high mark in my Aposuemi, and I was offered admission on merit, and that is how every student in Adekunle Ajashin has been admitted right now, and that has led to the robust quality students that are being produced in this school.
You can stay in your house, obtain your JAMB form, pass your JAMB, come for your post-UME, clear your post-UME papers, and be given admission. I'm an example. I didn't know anybody in this school. I passed my JAMB very well. I came for my post-UME. I did the same, and of course, I'm a student of this great institution.
Major developments also attest to the fact that the institution is poised to become a model of an ideal 21st century university. As a very first step, authorities of the university are primed for the wholesale re-engineering of the institution's processes, directed at making it a global recognized center of excellence in some core disciplines and subject areas.
Adekunle Ajashin University is seen as an excellent university, where scholarship is promoted, where academic excellence is seen in all ramifications. In terms of academic program, Adekunle Ajashin University is known for excellence. In terms of infrastructural facilities, Dekule Ajase University is also known as one of the best university with a good environment, conducive environment, study environment, and learning environment that you can find in Nigeria.
In the area of student support, apart from being virtually the least tuition fee paying in university in the country, the university administration established the Students Work Study Scheme in 2011 to give opportunities to students for out-of-class productive engagement. They work for a minimum of 2 hours per day, for which they are paid a stipend to help them get by while in school. There are testimonies from students who confirm that their schooling will have been terminated abruptly for lack of funds, but for the support they earn in the student work study scheme.
Benefits derived from it, majorly the financial aspect of it, is it's a welcome development. That payment has really helped some students to be able to do one or two things for, like, a person like me. The payments came in a time that I really needed money to be able to settle some things. And I saw some students that it helped them even to be able to pay their school fees. Some it helped them to be able to get their materials and one or two other things. So I think to a reasonable extent, it's a way in which the school helps the students.
The money I collected from it is what I used to pay my final year school fees. And the experience I learned from it.
Let me start by commending the university management for being student-friendly and student-focused. And this has prompted the university authority to actually put in place so many student-friendly programs. First among them is the work-study scheme, which was put in place by the past vice-chancellor of the university. The present vice-chancellor is also growing that program. In spite of paucity of funds, many of our indigent students are benefiting from that program. Recently, the check for those who participated in last semester have been awarded to the students.
In 2010, the university launched its campus bus shuttle scheme with a fleet of buses to ease the problem of transportation faced by staff and students within the university campus. While the Student Relaxation Center, a rendezvous for students, continues to be constantly upgraded. It is a place to be for students as it serves as an information center on campus where global socio-political events are monitored on cable television at all times. In the same vein, the university management employs the Vice Chancellor Student Leadership Forum, VCSLF, to create an opportunity for students to interface with management on all issues relating to their aspirations, challenges, and expectations on campus. Besides, the administration allows students to conduct elections into the organs of their union and govern themselves without interference. Complementing the creativity of the team in place in the university is a state government, the proprietor that has demonstrated so much commitment to the development of Adekunle Ajase University. The goal is to make AAUA a reference point in Nigeria and the world at large.
Kudos to the state government of Ondo State in person of Dr. Olusegun Rahman Miniko for giving us a befitting environment, an environment that attracts students, and then at a very lesser price. Comparing Adekunle Ajase University to other institutions, state institutions in Nigeria, you'll discover that Adekunle Ajase University is paying the lesser tuition fee. And then with the list of 25,000 naira that students are paying in Adekunle Ajase University, you have access to Earth Center. You have access to internet service, you have access to sporting facilities, you have access to wonderful classrooms, and then you have access to qualitative education.
On March 22, 2013, the visitor to the university and governor of Ondo State, Dr. Olusegun Miniko, inaugurated 6 building projects as part of the activities marking the university's 4th convocation ceremony. These include the 500-capacity Obafemi Awolowo Lecture Theatre, the University Electrification Project, the Vice Chancellor's Lodge, the University Guest House, the University Shopping Arena, and the University Gymnasium. Between 2009 to 2014, AAUA executed over 65 infrastructural projects to tackle the challenge of shortage of classroom, office, and laboratory space. Indeed, the number of physical projects delivered in the past few years is much more than the university executed in its first 10 years of existence. Some of the most compelling of these structures include the Senate Building, a five-story edifice of exquisite office space that accommodates all the administrative staff of the university, a 10-kilometer asphalt overlaid road network, the 500-capacity Obafemi Awolowo and Nelson Mandela Lecture Theater, the University Staff School, the University Health Center, the U Classroom Blocks, the University Internet Resource Center, the 60-shop shopping arena, the Bursary Village, and a major electrification project that extends electricity to a substantial part of the 820 hectares physical space of the university. There are also the TED Fund-supported 30-classroom quadrangle that accommodates 4,500 students at a time, the 600-capacity Umaruya Adua Lecture Theatre, and a new laboratory building designed to serve as temporary central laboratory. There are the NDDC-sponsored 450-capacity male hostel and the Osopadec-sponsored 550-capacity female hostel. Others include Center for Entrepreneurship Development, Computer-based Tech Center, CBT, Eastern Campus Gate, and the Senate Building Ceremonial Road, due for completion very soon. There is no doubt that the Adekunle Ajashin University has transformed from an innocuous school to a real university within the past 4 years.
AAUA has witnessed significant growth and development. In terms of development, of course, we can see physical structures. This Senate building, for instance, is one of the things that is fairly recent. We have a school anthem, we have a school flag, we have infrastructural development.
Say that I have practically grown with this system, being that I joined this system 2001, and when I joined the system, it was more like a secondary school, as it were. But 14 years now, we can talk about a befitting university.
Adekunle Ajashin University is a place where one can be proud of in terms of infrastructure, in terms of planning, even the beautification. Adekunle Ajashin University is presently a model for other universities in the country.
Adekunle Ajashin University is no more a glorified secondary school, as it was useful. Because I remembered that there was a time the late governor, Dr. Olusegun Agbabio, said that university was a glorified university. Things have changed, and now it is a university.
Kudos to the Federal Administration for actually transforming the environment, you know, under which students study here. And of course, that also is rubbing much on the quality of lectures and the products we are having from this university.
The hard work, commitment, and dedication underpinning governance in the university in more recent times are daily yielding results. Evidenced in March 2014 by the United States Transparency International Standard, USTIS, as the best state university in Nigeria. Earlier in the year, AAUA came first nationally in the 2013 Annual Youth Debate for Nigerian Tertiary Institutions, organized for all tertiary institutions in the country by the Federal Ministry of Education, Abuja. The National Universities Commission had way back in 2005 voted AAUA as the best state university in Nigeria and 8th best among all Nigerian universities in terms of quality of academic staff. Just recently, the Joint Admission and Matriculation Board, JAMB, named AAUA as the most subscribed university in Southwest Nigeria and the 20th most sought after Nigerian university.
The kinds of product that we send out into the world are the kinds that I'm very, very proud of. For example, in 2014, at the bar final exam at the law school, the best law graduate in Nigeria was our product, Papayemi Lunge. And our product scattered off all the most number of prizes at the law school in 2014. And it's not just in law.
The current phase of development of Adekunle Ajashin University is focused on deepening the integrity of its academic programs through improved and more socially relevant curricula, enhancement of the pedagogical prowess of its academics, and deepening of its cosmopolitan outlook, especially in staffing and student intake.
All our programs are fully accredited. We have quality and qualified lecturers, dedicated members of staff who teach the students both in their academic work and even in sporting activities. And you will also notice that in Adekunle Ajashin University, our admission is merit-driven.
Other institutes and centers were also floated. Among these are the AAUL Leadership Institute for Public Policy and Sustainable Development, the Women's Studies and Development Center, the Ajashin Varsity Theater, and the Teaching and Learning Center. The Linkage and International Programs Office was reconfigured to drive the university's commitment to institutional networking and consummating academic exchange programs with sister universities and sundry funding agencies across the world. What is more, AAUA's Public Lecture Series, designed to make the university a public policy crucible of some sort and a mechanism for town-gown interaction, has continued to deepen academic culture on campus and has now become a reference point nationally. The university has also revitalized its lecture series, including inaugural lectures, public lectures, faculty and departmental lectures, quality assurance seminars, and the likes are regularly held by professors, deans of faculties, directors of center and heads of department, and units to strategize on the way forward for the university.
No doubt about it, this university has gone a long way towards a grandiose improvement, because 10 years ago it was just a very dismal place. But now things are very much improved in terms of staff welfare, structural development, and our students are very much improved, because admission of students is merit based, promotion merit based, appointment merit based. So everything is very much improved, and we are moving very much towards attaining 21st century university properly called.
As a strong believer in the maxim that an institution is as good as its staff, the university management pays attention to staff welfare, putting in place staffing supporting packages even before industrial unions ask for them.
All staff are entitled to training. We encourage staff to go on a training, either overseas or locally, at least once a year. We have many people going abroad. We encourage them to go for overseas conferences and local conferences. With that, we have capacity building at every level for all staff. So the workforce is vibrant.
For instance, AAUA was the first conventional state university in Nigeria to adopt the salary component of the controversial 2009 federal government unions agreement. As at today, staff promotion cases are processed as and when due. The management has also instituted a life assurance policy for staff that is on march in any university across the country.
We have a group life assurance for all staff, all permanent staff. And this has assisted, because the university is one of the we are the first to put it in place in the university system. I am aware that some modern university systems have now joined. Loan facilities for staff, loan scheme. And we have three of them on stream. The housing loan, we have the furniture loan, and the motor vehicle refurbishing loan.
Beside publishing regulatory books not long ago, 21 of them in one fell swoop to put academic and administrative operations of the university on a sand pedestal. The university has also entrenched merit-driven admission and staff recruitment policies to enhance the integrity of its academic programs and hone the capacity of its workforce. Without doubt, the management has effected a paradigm shift and implanted a period of renaissance at AAUA that is perhaps unprecedented in the history of higher education in Nigeria in recent times. Small wonder, therefore, that today, Adekunle Ajashi University keeps attracting people from the nooks and crannies of Nigeria and across the world. It is obvious that Adekunle Ajashi University is one university that has become a platform for positive change, an institution irrevocably committed to becoming not just the best in Nigeria in a number of the most critical parameters, but also one to be reckoned with globally. Adekunle Ajashi University will continue to be a model and ideal place to be, as it has made a statement to the world in that building a world-class university is possible in this climate if the political will and institutional resolve are in place.
My vision for Adekunle Ajashi University is to sustain the current status of the university that is seen as the best state university in Nigeria in terms of academic excellence and scholarship, also in terms of discipline. By doing this, we also ensure that we move Adekunle Ajashi University to a higher level than the present level.
Welcome to Adekunle Ajashi University, Akungba Akoko, Ondo State, Nigeria, a young university eternally committed to producing globally competitive graduates, confident problem solver, adequate in character and learning, a major driver of national development and key player in the global drive towards sustainable development, a 21st century university properly called.
All hail Adekunle Ajashi University.